Intelligent enterprise is a way of having a infrastructure or an architecture which can change quickly and adapt as fast as digital business does change, but it's supported by the S4 engine, which is fast, quick, ultimately as fast as you want it, so it can act as fast as your customers can in the speed and volume that your customers actually need. Adaptable, quick, flexible, renewable, but also really, really fast because of the power of the S4 digital core. The first steps, you've got to do how, why, what, when. So I would start with the why. Why are you going to go to a digital business? What are the major things you need to do? What are the parts of the architecture that you need to support a digital business? Most actually, when we look at businesses, usually there is a reason, a really good reason. They want to go from being a wholesaler to a retailer. They want to go from a product company to a service company. They want to work in a batch of one. They want to do personalization, Internet of Things, Industry 4.0. There will be a huge business case that will be unleashed by having a digital business. So first of all, you've got to work out what will that digital business be. And then you've got to work out how you get there. And that is a lot more complex and a lot more difficult than people think. People have put in their SAP systems over many, many years. They're heavily bespoke. They don't really meet what's needed for today, but they are running your business. So to change that while you're moving to be a digital business at the same time is difficult, and working out how you do it as well as transforming your business and not disrupting your business is the hardest thing to do. Once you've got the why and the how, the other bits about when you do it, who you need, who you're going to partner with, how much it's going to cost, they should just fall out. But the first two bits is why and how. We realize that you will end up with a standard SAP core, which will be at the heart of your business, and then it will have the intelligent enterprise around it, which requires the flexibility, personalization, and agility that you need. We start with that principle. Lots of people don't. They still start with the, let's look at what you've got now, or let's look at what you've got in the future, let's produce a heavily bespoke system, or let's gather loads of requirements that are based on something you've got today, and then think about and build it for you, and then find out 3 years later it's not what you want. Capgemini start with the principle that we will be giving you a standard digital core, and then building flexibility around that, and we'll get that live quickly and get time to value quickly. We're one of the few people also to have the breadth of capability in different architectures and different technologies, and the scale to deliver it. That's really important. So I think we're great when it comes to the how and the why and which way we're going to do it, and we're also great in our ability to deliver at scale. The biggest challenge is changing the way you think about SAP and the digital core, and stop thinking it as a strong backbone to your business and think of it as a platform for a digital business. There'll be a lot of preconceived ideas within the business. Undoubtedly, the business has spent a lot of time and money putting in SAP many years ago, and they remember that. You've got to think about it in a new way. You've got to open your mind. You've got to open your mind to what your business could achieve, and then work out how the digital core will deliver it. Don't sit by thinking you can just do what you do now a little bit better and everybody will want it. It's about really having a different mindset and thinking about things differently. Work out the why, which really is quite quick, because if you don't know the why, you're a bit lost. You really should know why you want to be a digital business. That should be fairly easy. And then work out the how. When you've got the how, you'll be able to work out the when and the time and the cost, but you need to know now so you can plan for the future. Even if you're going to leave this for a couple of years, you need to do it now. And we can deliver this incrementally, so we could start with some small changes that could fund the rest. So that my thing is, why, how, big effort in the how.